Hello, my name is Florian and I welcome you to IT Tech Tips. In the Extending the Lab series, we're going to build upon our first series, Setting Up the Lab. So I assume that you have watched the videos of the first series and you have a working lab environment for our showcase company Acme Corp. Therefore, I will not go into much detail about topics we have already covered in the Setting Up the Lab series. For example, I assume that you know how to take a snapshot of a virtual machine, how to configure a network adapter in Windows, and how to ping a host, for example. So if you haven't watched the Setting Up the Lab series, I suggest that you do this now. The topics we are about to cover in the next few episodes, I'll show you after the introduction. Let's have a look. As I said in the introduction, we're going to build upon our basic lab, a company called Acme Corp with a real environment, which is close to a real life scenario in a smaller company. Make sure that you watch the episodes of the Setting Up the Lab series so you know what we're building up on here. In the Setting Up the Lab series, I've announced that the clients at the moment have a static IP configuration, but we'll have a dynamic IP configuration in the future. And that's what we're going to do in the next video. We're going to set up a DHCP server and configuring the clients. At the moment, we have also configured the Google DNS server for the clients to resolve host names to IP addresses. And we're going to change that so we have our own DNS server in our environment, so we have control over the lookups. We are then going to set up an Active Directory, which is the primary purpose of our server acme-dc01. DC stands for Domain Controller. And in this Active Directory, we can then create user accounts and security groups for allowing the clients to log in the domain environment in the later episodes. We are going to create a file structure, which will be really simple, but could be used in a real life environment for a smaller company. And we're going to make sure that the files in this file structure are accessed in a secure way by using the security groups we've created. And then we're going to perform some really basic automation tasks with the login script so that the clients are automatically connected to this file structure we've created to make life simpler and more centralized for the IT department. Last but not least, we're going to enforce some settings in the domain environment by using group policy objects, which is already a slightly more advanced topic. Most topics we're going to cover in the Extending the Lab series are considered legacy technology. So this technology will partially be gone in a few years from now because of the whole cloud topic and the migration from legacy services and environments to cloud services. But it is still important to understand how this legacy technology works so you have a better understanding in the future for the migration path. You now have a general idea about what we're going to do in the next episodes in the Extending the Lab series. In the next video, we're going to cover the DHCP topic, meaning that the clients will get a dynamic IP address. If you don't want to miss any topic in the Extending the Lab series, I suggest that you subscribe and ring the bell. See you next time.